Hi everyone, it's the Phantom of the Math here, and today we are going to talk about the problem that bothers most young students when they are first introduced to a formula for the circles. So they're often wondering, why is the circumference of a circle equal to 2 pi r, and why is the formula for the area of the circle r squared pi? Well, we're going to try to answer these questions today. So, let's first get to the first question, and that is, why is the circumference of a circle 2 pi r? We have all learned in math classes that the circumference of a circle with radius r is equal to 2 pi r. Okay, but why is that? Why is the formula written in this way? Well, first of all, let's try to understand what pi actually is. And if you look at the math books, they will tell you that if you draw a circle with a radius r and a diameter d, the ratio between the circumference of the circle and diameter is equal to pi. So basically, pi is equal to circumference of a circle over its diameter. Well, this is actually correct, but we know that the value of the diameter of the circle is equal to the twice of the value of its radius. And then we will soon realize that it's just the same as our first formula, only it's written differently. So we need to seek our answers elsewhere. We need to talk about the relationship between the pi and the angles. There are two ways to measure angles in mathematics. We can measure angles in degrees, or we can measure angles in radians. Both degrees and radians are measurement for the angles, they are only described by different units. If you are relatively new in mathematics, you can think about it this way. For example, if you live in the United States, your local weather forecast can say that today's temperature is 50 degrees Fahrenheit. On the other hand, if you live in Russia, your local weather forecast can say that today's temperature is 10 degrees Celsius. Both of these represent the same temperature value, it is only measured in a different units. The same thing applies for our angles. It can be measured in degrees or in radians. What does that mean for the angles? And what is exactly the relationship between radians and degrees? And what does that have to do with a pi? Well, in the simplest terms, the pi radians is equal to 180 degrees. Maybe even the better way to think about this is that half circle is equal to pi, and that is 180 degrees. That means that pi over 2 radians is equal to 90 degrees, and that is quarter of the circle. And the most important for us, 2 pi radians is equal to 360 degrees, and that represents the full circle. Remember this last one, because this one is going to be important for us. And now, let's head back to the circumference. Let's start with the center of the circle O, and from it we will draw the radius of the circle R. If we imagine that we put the tip of our pencil at the end point P of our radius and try to draw a circle, what do you think? Which angle do we need to cover in order to draw a full circle? Well, you probably guessed it, it's 360 degrees, or, as we mentioned before, 2 pi in radians. Let's now head back to our circumference. Since the circumference of the circle represents the length of the outer line of the circle, that means that our formula must be 2 pi, since the 2 pi represents angle that we need to cover with the tip of our pencil, times the distance between the tip of our pencil and the center of the circle, and that is our radius r. And there you have it, we have our circumference formula. You can use this method not only to calculate the circumference of a circle, but you can also calculate the length of any circular arc. For example, if we have a circle with a radius of, let's say, 5, and we want to calculate the length of the circular arc L over 30 degree angle, we can do this easily with our previous formula. So, as we said before, the length L must be equal to our angle that we covered times the distance from the tip of our pen to the center of the circle, and that is the radius r. Since in this example our angle is equal to 30 degrees, we need to translate it into radians. We know that pi is equal to 180 degrees, so 180 over 6 is 30 degrees, and that means that pi over 6 radians is equal to 30 degrees. Now, we can switch this into our formula, and we have that L is equal to pi over 6 times radius r. And if we enter the values, we get 3.14 for pi over 6 times 5. And the approximate length of our circular arc, in this case, will be 2.62. So, you can do this for any other example of the circular arc. Now we know the explanation for the circumference formula. But what about the area of the circle? Why is the area of the circle equal to r squared pi? In order to find out, we first need to draw a circle with a center O and a radius r. Now, we will put the point A at the intersection of the radius and the outer line of the circle. Let's now imagine that we take a pair of scissors and cut the outer line of our circle just beneath its intersection with our radius at point A. Then, we will stretch the outer line of the circle to form the 90 degree angle with our radius and put the point B at the end of the line. Now, our line AB will be equal to the circumference of the circle 2 pi r. We will connect the point O and the point B, and we will get the right triangle OAB. The area of our circle will actually be equal to the area of the right triangle OAB. All we need to do is find the area of this triangle. We all know that we can get the area of the right triangle by multiplying its legs OA and AB and dividing it by 2. Now, we will just replace the length OA with the radius r and AB with circumference 2 pi r. We will cancel 2 and 2, and if we multiply r and r, we will get r squared, so that is the area of the circle that equals r squared pi, and this is our formula. I hope this video gave you some insights about how we got to these formulas and clarified all things that you didn't understand about them. If you liked this video and learned something new, please give it a like, share it, or maybe subscribe to the channel so that you can stay in touch with the more awesome math content that we will provide in future. Till next time, see you all!